Essentially, it's a struggle over political control that can exist at many different levels.
A civil war is when a state dissolves into violent conflict because of internal factions that drive disagreements into conflict that is actually violent.
Traditionally, civil wars are fought between the state and some sort of rebel group that's hoping for either autonomy or to capture the state. I think now we see more complicated civil wars in which we have economic groups hoping to just use the chaos to make a profit. We have a lot of international involvement from external states, so that there's really a blurred line between civil and international war.
Civil wars are critical issues.
Some issues are enduring. That is, they do generate humanitarian crises in areas where they take place.
We have seen over the past several decades that civil wars have been effectively resolved one way or another. And the question, as we see this uptick in civil wars, particularly with the four wars in the Middle East, the question is, how do we address them now, and what trends are they indicating for us?
The consequence of civil wars. There are consequences of civil wars. Includes refugee crisis, the creation of ungoverned spaces, the collapse of states, which will have an implication to international peace and security.
And in my work, we say it's not in our time that women and children are on the front line. They are the front line, that they are targeted in the wars of our time. When we look at areas of conflict, that there are so many dimensions that have to be brought to bear in trying to understand them if there is to be ever any chance of bringing them to an end.
We're not going to create in countries that are going through a civil war, we're not going to create Denmark or Switzerland. But there's a between that and being in the midst of the horrors of a war, there's a lot of progress that can be made.